Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Hello everyone and welcome back to the PL-300 exam preparation series where we are looking at the first learning path, prepare the data. We have been exploring the topic create and transform columns, and this is going to be the last video on this topic. We have seen a lot of transformations that have been performed on some of the queries shown here within the data model, like the customers table, like the products table, stores, calendar and transaction data. But in this video, we are not going to look at any further transformation. Instead, we are going to look at the M script that has been generated for each of these transformations. So on the right side of the screen, this is the area where you see the applied steps. So here in the applied steps, for every transformation, there is a step associated and is shown here in the applied steps area. If we want to see all of these transformations together, then we need to go into the home menu, and here in the query option, in this area where we have the query option, we have the advanced editor. So I'm just going to click on the advanced editor here, and it is going to open up a new window. And then in this video, you will see that for every transformation that has been done, one line of M script has been generated. So from an exam point of view, you should be knowing some of the very well-known M functions that are used for different transformations. So for example, this is the last transformation that we did, which was added conditional column. And here you can see the M script that has been generated. So inside this M script, this is the part table.addColumn, which is the function that has been used. Similarly, where the data type was changed, we have another function which says table.transformColumnTypes. So for all the other transformations on the other queries, we have seen there are different M functions that are associated and are used. In terms of the PL-300 exam, you are not supposed to write any M code, but there can be questions which relate to some of the functionalities associated with the transformations that we have seen. And we must know what functions are used in the M language for each of these transformations. So now I'm going to take you to my browser and I'm going to show you that where these M functions are available, and you need to just see some of the well-known functions and you should be able to interpret what the code is actually doing. So I am in my browser window now, and here you can see that the page that I have opened, it refers to the Power Query M function reference, and this is the link which will be available in the resources that you need to just put in your browser, and you will be able to see the different functions that are there in the M language. So here it says that there are more than 700 functions. So it is almost impossible for anybody to remember all the functions, but you should focus on just knowing how these functions work. Some of the well-known functions, you just need to focus on how these functions work. So if I just scroll down here, you see that the functions have been divided into different categories. So here we have categories for accessing data functions, binary functions, combiner functions, comparer functions, and so on and so forth. So all of this is actually the code that is generated for whatever operations we perform in the Power Query editor. So here some of the important areas are related to the accessing data functions, then some of the functions related to the table functions and text functions. So I'm just going to randomly open a few functions. So I've just clicked on the text functions. So here you can see that all the functions which are related to the data type text or which are applied on text columns, you can see here, and some of the functions you can just go and open it up. So for example, if I just go and I click on the text.split function here. So here it says that the text.split function, here is the syntax of that function. And here it says that it returns a list of text values resulting from the splitting a text value based on the specified delimiter. So here you can see the usage of this particular M function, and it shows that this is an example that how you can use this M function and what is going to be the output of this M function. So remember, we have already seen that what is the purpose of these curly brackets, what are the square brackets, what are the round brackets. So just need to understand how the M functions actually work. So there are two ways. The easiest way is that you just go back and see the M functions that have been used in the example that we have been doing, and then just refer to this particular reference function list where you can find what each function is doing. So some of the very well-known functions, like changing the data type, like adding a column, like splitting a column, like merging different columns, like how to create a conditional column, how to create a custom column, all of these functions, just see the relevant M code and then come here in the browser window and just go through the syntax and how that M code has been generated and how you can interpret that code. So this video brings to an end to this very important topic of creating and transforming different queries in Power Query Editor. So expect at least a couple of questions related to either the UI or the options inside the Power Query Editor related to all of this, or something related to the M functions that I have just shared with you. There are going to be a few other transformations that will be covered in some of the other videos, but these are the major transformations that have been covered. We are going to do a few operations related to data cleaning, which are again are going to be some kind of transformations, but those are primarily related to the data cleaning activity, and the functions associated with those we will be covering in those videos. So that's all for this topic, and I will see you in the next one.